Blue light keeping you awake at night? Do you have eye strain? What the heck do you do? I've got your answers. Most individuals have spent over a year now working from home, glued to the laptops and other digital screens, and now you're experiencing eye strain and headaches due to this. So what in the world do you do? Today, I'm going to break down the truth behind blue light health consequences and what you can do right now to stop digital screen eye strain. Hey everyone, I'm Dr. Jordan Wagner. I'm an emergency room doctor who treats everything from COVID to gunshot wounds, burns, you name it. I've created this video series to help answer some of your medical questions and the questions that I get from patients each and every day. If you find this video helpful, please do me a favor and subscribe. Let's first understand the science of what blue light actually is. Blue light is a type of visible light on the light spectrum, and it has a short wavelength. Due to this short wavelength, blue light rays contain more energy than many other light types. In fact, blue light isn't just produced by artificial sources only. We actually see blue light naturally every time we look up at the sky. But here's the deal. For thousands of years, humans were exposed to blue light only during the hours that the sun was up. And our brains were trained to interpret blue light as a cue to be awake, alert, energetic, and ready for action. Being and feeling alert is good, but too much exposure to blue light, on the other hand, can cause adverse effects as well. For starters, if you're exposed to too much blue light during the day, your eyes can grow fatigued. But you may say to me, "Doc, my eyes are tired, but my body is wide awake. What the heck is happening?" Well, blue light may be disturbing your health in other ways, such as your sleep patterns. The way this works is the blue light sends signals to your brain that can affect your body's production of melatonin. This can make it hard to fall asleep and stay asleep after using your devices at night. And beyond sleep quality, melatonin disruption throws off the entire hormone balance in your body, which in turn affects your overall health and well-being. Poor sleep quality can also change the way that your body feels stress. When you aren't getting REM sleep, your mind isn't able to fully relax. So, how do you reduce blue light effects in your life? We've seen them everywhere, those trendy blue light glasses, but do they actually work? Right now, the evidence for blue light glasses as a preventative measure for reducing blue light exposure is mixed. The American Academy of Ophthalmology doesn't currently recommend special blue light filtering glasses for use when you work with computers. This may change in the future. There's a study that is currently underway to more comprehensively examine whether blue light glasses have definitive benefits. A 2017 study from Ophthalmic and Physiologic Optics found that three clinical trials had poor evidence to support the use of blue light blocking glasses to preserve eye health and prevent dry eyes. However, there are several lifestyle tips for reducing blue light exposure. You don't have to purchase blue light glasses to reduce your exposure to blue light. Number one, protect your eyes from eye strain and fatigue by adopting some eye health friendly habits, including taking eye breaks from your screens or dim the lights in your home or workspace. Number two, you can even consider using red light as opposed to an LED bulb as a night light in your bedroom. Red light is less likely to disrupt your circadian rhythm because red wavelengths are much shorter. Number three, try a filter on your screen, or I highly recommend switching your device to night mode for certain hours of the day. These filter the amount of blue light your screen gives off. If you've tried some of these tips, but you're not experiencing the type of relief that you'd hope for, then it might be time to speak to your doctor. Blue light exposure may already be causing you to have continued symptoms like eye strain and dry eye. As far as blue light glasses go, the definitive verdict is still out on their ability to substantially reduce your exposure to blue light and the associated symptoms of exposure. But limiting blue light exposure, adopting habits to take better care of your eyes, and taking breaks from your screens can all help you avoid dry eyes and eye strain caused by blue light exposure. If these symptoms don't resolve with lifestyle changes and self-care strategies within a short span of time, I highly recommend you speak with an eye doctor about them sooner rather than later. All right, that's been a blue light breakdown with me, Dr. Wagner. Do you wear blue light glasses or practice any daily eye strain tips? Be sure to drop me a comment below. Please make sure that you subscribe and turn your bell notifications on right here. When you do that and you hit that like button, you let YouTube know that you want to see more videos like this one. Thank you so much for watching, and stay healthy, my friends.